046，
我这下来在哪里？然后
哎呀，Blue skies and rainbows and sunbeams from heaven south. I can see where my Lord is leading me. I know Jesus is and I to live. He makes his home in my heart. Never more I be alone. See, promise me that
Oh,
we never will part. Green grass and flowers so green in springtime. Our soft master, I live for each day. I know that Jesus is bound and love today. He makes his own be my own. Never more I be alone. See, promise me that we never will part. Oh, mountains, rivers, valleys, and beauties surround me. Don't make me aware of the one thing that I know. Jesus is today. He's on in my heart. Promise me that we never will part. I know that Jesus is love today. He makes his home in my heart. Never more I be alone. See, promise me that we never will part. Promise me that we never will part.
Man, okay, this is your song.
Okay, 好的啊，My Lord, he and my Lord, he and my Lord, he and what he say do. He done give us Jesus. He done, he done give us Jesus. He done die, he done give us Jesus. He done die, he done die. What he say, do
my Lord,
my Lord. He done die, my Lord. He done die, my Lord. He done die, he done die. What he say, do. He done give us love. He done die, he done give us love. He done done, he done give us love. He done done, he done done what he say do. My Lord. He done done, my Lord. He done done, my Lord. He done done, he done done what he say do. He done give us joy. He done done, he done give us joy. He done done, he done give us joy. He done done, he done done what he say to my Lord. Ma'am.
Okay, sit down. Okay, we continue. E049 and to deal lot. And to the old Lord, do I live out my soul? And to the old Lord, do I live out my soul? Oh my God, I trust in thee. Amen. Okay. You will lead us in the prayer.
Okay，让我们来低头向神祷告。Amen， 天上的神，伟大的父，很感谢神，可以让我们有一个星期五可以聚在这里，然后一起去唱歌，一起去听这样一个 Deming 的 lesson， 然后来去敬拜神你，然后也去向神你学习，然后。去度过一个更好的生命。那请求神可以保守今天晚上的一切，然后还有保守 Uncle Day Lesson 可以就很好的传达给我们每个人，传达神的话语你，然后给我们每个人。请求神可以保守这一切，奉主耶稣名祷告 ，Amen。
Amen。阿门。Okay。Chinese song， 马上。Chinese song。C021
主的喜乐是我力量，你的救恩是我盼望。虽然橄榄树不效力，也许葡萄树不结果，我仍依旧我的生活心快乐。主的喜乐是我力量，你的救恩是我盼望。虽然橄榄树不效力，也许葡萄树不结果，
我饮酒忘离身，欢心快乐。我要在你，无论的是或非的事，我要在你每天从日出到日落，我心坚定与你。每天赞美你不停，我要赞美，跳舞赞美，我要赞美，自由赞美，大声欢呼，你是永远的神君王。主的喜乐是我力量，你的救恩是我盼望。虽然橄榄树不效力，也许葡萄树不结果，我的灵就一生欢喜快乐。我要赞美，无论的是我不好的事，我要赞美。每天从日出到日落，我心决定与你，每天赞美不停，我要赞美，跳舞赞美，我要赞美，自由赞美，大声欢呼，你是永远的神君王。我要赞美，无论的是或非，但是我要赞美，每天从日出到日落，我心坚定与你。每天赞美不停，我要赞美，跳舞赞美，我要赞美，自由赞美，我要赞美，跳舞赞美，我要赞美，自由赞美，大声欢呼，你是永远的神君王。
很不错 ，OK 哎，
你先没说，想要说，
好，OK， 西吉罗猪猪，因为他是万王之王，因为他是万主之主。唯有他从死里复活，我要敬拜他，因为他是万王之王，因为他是万主之主。唯有他从死里复活，我要敬拜他，我的信仰未来，我的荣耀成为耶稣基督，他是主，万心仰未来，万口仰称耶稣基督，他是主。高唱荣耀，哈利路亚。很不容易，哈利路亚！他是我的主，我的灵魂，我要敬拜他。哈利路亚，哈利路亚！耶稣基督，他是主。耶稣基督，他是主。
阿门。
Amen.
Okay, thank you.
Amen. So we have a new translator here. Amen. Awesome, huh? So who haven't done yet?
David.
David. Soon. Okay, can I escape it, huh? Everyone must try. Women haven't tried, huh? Amen. Okay. So let's see, where are we? Off weapon. Can you check? Okay, welcome everyone. Very good to see all of you. 很高兴看到你们. Amen. Okay, and today we will continue on our lesson. It went off. Oh, 关掉了，做么? Okay, went off. So we wait for a few minutes, okay? This Sunday we have this weekend. Tomorrow I'm going to KL for a special budget meeting. 明天我去吉隆坡啊，有一个 meeting. So this Sunday we have a special guest speaker. 这个礼拜星期天我们有一个特别的讲员啊，讲员啊。Who is it? Mr. Ringo from Hong Kong. Okay, you get to hear Hong Kong message. Amen. Hong Kong style message. Amen. I look forward. I know he'll do a great job and we can all learn a lot from him. All right. The light is off. Projector is off. It's auto off. You know. Okay, all right, you went back on, yay! All right. Okay, so we've been talking about the training of the first disciples. And I hope you've been learning a lot and applying it to your small group.
我希望你们从当中已经学到很多，并且把它应用在你们的小组上。
Again, this is about your small group, the group that you're in.
然后这个是关于我们小组里面的分享。
Again, so that you know how a small group functions.
然后这让你知道一个小组是怎么样运作的。
So the church is built out of many small groups.
所以呢，我们的教会是由很多个小组来组成的。
Like the bricks, right? On the wall, many little bricks build the whole building.
就很像我们屋子上面的砖块一样，我们屋子也是通过很多个砖块去达成的。
Wow, very good. You know, a few years ago, he couldn't understand my English.
Okay.
Amen. Very proud of you. Okay. So as you know, the objective of our study is so that we can all grow to spiritual maturity.
所以呢，我们要知道我们这次的目标是为了达成我们属灵上的成熟。
So the function of a small group, all the studies that we are doing is encompassed by these three main points. The function of our small group is defined by these three main points. Difficult. How? Define. How do you say define?
定义。 所以我们小组的功能是被定义在这三个要点上面。
It's about our connection to God, our connection to each other.
它是关于我们与神之间，还有我们彼此之间的联系。
It's about our own personal spiritual growth.
它是关于我们个人上的属灵成长。
And about our evangelism and spreading the good news to our communities. It's about our evangelism to the community.
它是关于到我们会去传福音，还有对彼此分享好消息。
Amen. Okay, so today we're going to talk about very important aspect, grow together.
所以今天我们会说到很重要的部分，就是共同成长。
So, I start off with the opening question. Is spiritual growth a New Testament concept?
让我们从一个问题作为开始。灵性成长是新约圣经的概念吗？
So often you read in the New Testament, it tells you, oh, you need to strive to grow, make every effort to grow.
我们在读新约圣经的时候，他总是告诉我们，我们要不断的去成长。
And sometimes we look at it and we think, oh, spiritual growth are for Christians, a New Testament concept.
然后这个时候，我们就会想到说，我们属灵上的成长是从新约来的，
Okay, it's a Jesus teaching.
然后它都是关于耶稣的教导。
But Jesus is God.
哦，但是耶稣是神。
So whatever he taught in the New Testament, he would have also taught in the Old Testament.
然后他会在新约教的，那当然他也会在旧约同时教导我们。
So let's read a few verses. Let's start with Leviticus chapter 19, verse 2.
让我们从一个章节开始，它是利未记的第19章第二节。你要告诉以色列全体会众，对他们说：“你们要分别为圣，因为我耶和华你们的神是圣洁的。
So, you know, here, God, right, Jesus in the Old Testament, God is saying, be holy, grow to be holy, just as I am holy.
”所以，神对我们说：“你们要变得圣洁。”就好像我一样，
Okay, so God is telling them in the Old Testament, grow and be holy.
然后所以这边就看得出来说，神在旧约的时候就对我们说，我们要成长，并且变得更加圣洁。
So it's not a just a New Testament concept.
New Testament concept，所以它不只是新约里面的概念。
Let's read Psalm chapter 92, verse 12 and 14.
然后我们来读诗篇第92章第12节到第14节。一人必像棕树一样繁茂，像黎巴嫩的香柏树一样高耸。他们栽在耶和华的殿中，在我们神的院子里繁茂成长。他们年老的时候仍要结果子，并且保持繁茂青翠。
So here, God in the Old Testament talks about how each of the followers in the Old Testament is like a tree.
神说，神在旧约里面说，我们的义人像是一个树一样的繁茂。
Right? Like a tree, you will grow.
然后那个树会越来越长越高。
And even at old age, you are still growing.
不管是在我们年老的时候，它也是一样会继续成长。
So again, you find the concept of growth also was in the Old Testament.
所以这边我们又看得出来，成长这个东西，其实在旧约里面就有提到了。
And then here in Proverbs chapter 1, verse 5, let's read that.
然后我们来看箴言第1章第5节。使智慧人听了可以增长学问，使聪明人听了可以获得智谋。
So here again, God calls the disciples in the Old Testament, grow, add to your learning.
所以这边我们又可以看到，神又在旧约里面提醒我们，我们要成长，然后我们要去学习。
Right? And even if you think you're wise, you still need to grow.
即使我们已经认为自己足够聪明，但是我们还是要继续的去成长。
So, growth is not just a New Testament concept. It's all the way starting from the book of Genesis until Revelation.
所以我们这边能看得出，成长不只是新约的教导和概念，它是从我们创世纪一路到我们的启示录，都一直在这样教导着我们。
That's why in the New Testament, God continue on with this concept about growing. Let's read 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 16.
让我们来读彼得前书第一章第十六节。因为圣经上记着说，你们要圣洁，因为我是圣洁的。
Right, same concept, right? New Testament, Old Testament. So the challenge and the command is keep growing so that you can be holy in the Lord.
所以我们可以看到，我们在旧约跟新约上，神都一直教导着我们，提醒着我们，我们要成长，那样我们才能在属灵中变得更加的圣洁。
So as disciples in our small group, we got to keep helping one another to grow in Christ.
那么身为神的门徒呢，我们在我们自己的小组中，我们当然要互相扶持我们的弟兄姐妹，让我们一起彼此去成长。
So this is a very important concept. I'm going to talk about six ways each of us can help each other to grow in our small group.
那这边我们来要讲很重要的东西，那就是圣经教导我们共同成长的六种方式，让我们可以应用在我们的小组当中。
So helping each other to grow in the small group is not just the job of the leader.
那当然呢，帮助彼此成长并不只是小组里面的组长的工作。
No, it's everyone in that small group.
是我们每一个人在每一个小组里面都应该要进行一个工作。
So we as disciples in the small group need to own that small group.
我们身为我们的门徒呢，在我们自己的小组，当然我们也要为我们的小组尽一份力。
Correct. Wow, good. Okay, again, own your small group. This is my small group. Yeah, that's the feeling. This is my small group. That is that feeling.
Okay, 我们要有一种思想，就是这是我的小组，我需要为他做点什么。
I want to help all the brothers and the sisters in my group to grow at the same time as I grow.
当然，我自己成长的同时呢，我要一起去帮助我的弟兄姐妹们一起跟我的成长。
So, amen, you ready? Very important.
那准备好了吗？接下来的会很重要。
Alright, first concept, okay, first way is and build each other up with encouragement.
我们的第一点就是我们要彼此鼓励，彼此造就。
So let's read 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 11.
那我们一起来读《帖撒罗尼迦前书》第五章第十一节。所以你们应该彼此劝慰，互相造就，正如你们一向所行的。
So the picture here is what? Like a building, slowly building up to the sky.
所以我们就要彼此就像一个，这里带给我们的一个画面就是，我们就是一个建筑。我们会越堆叠越高，直到我们高到跟那个天空一样高。
Okay, very good. All right, amen, awesome. Okay, you know, so that's how you got to visualize your small group.
这就是我们如何去比喻、去看待我们的小组。
Right, my present, your present in the small group needs to help your small group to be built up, to grow.
那我们在这个小组里面，我们如何去壮大？这就是我们互相努力出来的成果。
Right, so first way is by encouraging one another.
所以我们第一步就是我们要互相的去劝勉。
So encouraging comes from the word courage.
然后劝勉这个字，它是从鼓励作为我们的基底。
So in other words, give courage to one another.
所以顾名思义就是我们要去鼓励彼此。
So how do we give courage to one another?
那我们要如何鼓励彼此？
Alright, so we use our, one way is you use your words to give courage to one another.
嗯，我们当然可以用我们的话语去互相鼓励。
You know, supporting each other.
然后可以行动上去支持他们。
Most of us grow up with the mindset to help somebody to grow, we have to just challenge.
Oh.
We have to scold.
Scold.
Yeah, to help someone to grow, scold them.
嗯，我们有时候为了鼓励彼此，我们会需要去挑战他们。
Right? That's how we learn most of the time, not all the time, in our homes.
嗯，这也就是我们多数时候我们会做的事情。
Right? Or in the school, your teacher scold you. Why so stupid? Right?
嗯，然后当然在学校也是，老师在鼓励你的时候也是会用一些比较严厉的口吻，会说为什么你连这一点东西都做不好。
And they feel the more scolding and the more you grow.
然后他们就会觉得他们骂的越多，你进步的就越快。
And for certain people, it does help. For a small percentage of people.
嗯，当然对一小部分的人，真的是很一小部分的人，这个方法的确是很有效的。
But for majority of people like us, too many scolding, we become very small.
嗯，当然对于我们大部分人来讲，过多的责骂会使我们的心灵越来越的渺小。
So encourage means what? You say things to build up.
那鼓励这个字是什么呢？是我们互相去通过一些方式去建造我们彼此之间的动力。
Okay, example, after this, make sure you encourage Yu Heng.
然后当然在这个之后，你们也可以来鼓励一下我。
Okay, like, hey, Yu Heng, that was very good, very proud of you for taking that courage to do translation.
嗯，然后这时候你就可以讲，宇恒，我对你很自豪。就是很感谢你可以对我们做翻译的工作。
Right? That's one way, right? You build him up, then he has more courage to do it again.
嗯。嗯，所以这个我们就给了一个很好的例子，这个就是可以来鼓励彼此的方式。
Amen? 再来啊。Okay, so learn to encourage each other.
嗯，所以我们要学习如何去鼓励彼此。
Another way to encourage each other is to walk with one another.
Walk.
To support each other by being with each other. Partner with each other.
嗯，对，所以另外一个鼓励彼此的方式是我们要走在一起。
Right? When you do things alone, it's difficult. It's scary.
嗯，当我们一个人在做某些事情的时候，我们总是会感到害怕和无力。
But when you are doing it together, you feel more courageous.
那当然呢，我们有人陪伴在我们身边，一起去做某件事情的时候呢，我们就会感受到那个鼓励。
Okay, I can still remember, you know, my dad, I love my dad. To teach me how to be bold, he sent me out alone to collect money from customer.
嗯，那也就要提到我的爸爸，
我的爸爸，
嗯 ，teach me a lot.
What he wanted to teach me how to be a businessman.
嗯，所以他从小就很想教导我如何成为一个生意人。
Right, so he said, "You go collect money."
所以他就对我说，你去帮我收钱。
And I was a small kid, okay? Younger than him.
嗯，所以当时呢，我还是一个小孩。
Right, I was terrified going alone.
嗯，所以我对于一个人要去做那些事情很害怕。
You know, I can walk around that building, the shop 10 times. I don't want to go in.
对，我可以绕着我等一下要进去的地方走一个十圈都还没有走进去。
Alright, but you know, my father's staff employee go with me, no problem.
嗯，可是呢，当我爸爸的员工说他要跟我走一起过去的时候呢， 那我就觉得我完全不害怕, 我可以随时去。
And I learned so much from my father's employee.
当然呢,我也从我爸爸员工身上学到了很多东西。
I learned how he talked to customers.
我跟他学习了如何跟顾客交流。
I learned how to do banking old-fashioned way.
Banking.
I go to the bank, how to deposit money old-fashioned way.
我当然我也学会了如何使用一些银行的东西，像提款机这样的东西。
Okay, over. You won't know what old-fashioned way is. But anyway, okay, the old. Yeah, anyway. But you see, going together, encourage one another.
就如刚刚所说的，我们要走在一起，然后去互相鼓励。
Okay, that's why your presence in that small group encourage each other to be strong. That's why you need to be there. In other words, your presence is important for that small group.
所以这就是为什么我们很需要去互相的鼓励，在我们的小组里面。
Oh, don't look at your leader. Wow, leader very strong. Don't need me.
不要只单单的去敬仰着你的组长，觉得你的组长哇，他很强。 他可以去带领我们做任何事情，他应该不需要我去为他出这一份力。
Even your leader is a human being. Your leader is also a human being.
当然你的组长也是人，他不可能一手包办所有的事情。
Okay, so your presence there helps him to also be strong. Your presence in the group helps him to be strong.
当然你的出现可以让我们的小组变得更加的强大。
Alright, so that's the first way. Build one another up with encouragement.
所以这就是我们的第一步，我们要彼此鼓励，彼此造就。
Then secondly, we need to what? Warn one another against sinful living.
Against sinful living.
Warn one another about sin.
然后第二个呢，就是我们要互相的去劝告，在于我们的罪上面。
Let's read Hebrews chapter 3, verse 12 and 13.
那我们来读希伯来书第3章第12到第13节。弟兄们，你们要小心，免得你们中间有人存着邪恶、不信的心，以致离弃了永活的神。趁着还有叫做今天的时候。 总要天天互相劝勉，免得你们中间有人受了罪恶的诱惑，心里就刚硬了。
So the Bible says here, sin is very deceitful.
所以圣经里面说，罪这个东西是很可怕的。
Sin is like what? Like scammers, people who scam you.
所以罪这个东西，它就像一个骗子。
Right? Then you get a phone call or you get a WhatsApp, a message that looks so real.
然后有时候你会接到一些电话还是WhatsApp, 他们看起来都很真实。
And they entice you, they tempt you to want to click that button.
然后他们会去吸引你，会去想要接起那一封电话，或者是点开那个他发送来的邮件。
Right? There's always the promise of, you know, of wonderful thing and riches.
然后他总是会承诺你一些很美好的事情，比如说可能你中了一只 iPhone. 那
Did you get it before?
Yeah.
Right? Then you feel like, hey, look real. Then you click gone.
然后当你觉得可能有希望的时候，你一点下去，你就够力了。
Okay. So sin is like that. It looks innocent. And it looks tempting.
所以罪就是看起来像那个邮件这样的东西，它很有诱惑。
So to be able to escape from sin, we in the small group have to learn to warn each other about these sins.
所以呢，为了让我们从罪中脱离出来，我们身为小组的一员，我们当然也要互相去劝告，让我们远离我们的罪。
Of course, it is sometimes a little bit scary to tell another person, hey bro, don't do that.
当然有时候我们会很胆怯，当我们注意到有人做不对的事情时，我们总是没有办法第一时间去告诉他们, 你不能这么做。
Right? Because you are afraid they will reject you.
因为你会害怕他们会拒绝你。
But better they reject you than you don't warn them of the potential danger.
当然呢，比起他们拒绝你，你要更加担心的是他们所犯的罪是否有一些潜在的威胁。
But at least you warn them, you've done your job. They make their own choice, but you make your, you give your warning.
不管他们听不听呢，至少你去提醒他们的时候，你已经做了你应该做的本分。
But you find most of the time, they will learn from your warning.
但大部分的时候，只要你肯开口，他们总会意识到自己的错误，并且听取你的教训。
Okay, so that's the second way we grow together, by warning each other about sins and temptations in our lives.
所以这个就是我们第二步，我们成长的过程，那就是我们要彼此的对于我们的罪进行劝诫。
All right, number three.Teach one another from the Bible.
我们的第三步是我们要互相劝导。
Let's read Romans chapter 15, verse 14.
那我们一起来读罗马书第十五章第十四节。我的弟兄们，我个人深信你们自己也蛮有良善，充满丰富的知识，也能够彼此劝导。
So here Paul is telling the disciples, you need to what? Teach each other.
所以保罗在这边他就跟我们说，我们其实蛮有智慧的，所以我们要去互相的去教导。
I love Apostle Paul. When he looked at the disciples, he always see their potential. He always see that they can do it.
所以保罗总是能够发觉就是我们能够做的东西。
Alright, so sometimes we look at ourselves, we think, oh, I'm a younger Christian, or I'm not very good in the Bible, or, you know, I'm not the leader. So we are afraid, right, to teach.
可是每当我们有时候去审视自己的时候，我们可能会想，哦，我才刚成为基督徒没有多久啊。然后我在我的小组里面，我时常帮不到什么忙啊。这些自负的话，总会让我们去有一个警戒的心，不敢去教导别人。
Right, we look down on ourselves.
因为我们会看扁自己。
Okay, so God says you have the potential. You are full of goodness.
可是呢，神在这里跟我们说，我们有那个能力。然后我们蛮有良善。
So teach, no worry, just teach what you know from the Bible.
所以我们不要去胆怯，不管你从圣经上面学到什么，我们都要去大方勇敢的去教导。
Learn to use the Bible.
学会把圣经当成你的武器。
In your conversation, right? Like when you want to warn a brother or a sister, open the Bible, show them the word of God.Teach them the word of God.
当你要劝导你的弟兄或姐妹的时候，你就可以把圣经当成是你的语言。你可以翻开其中一个章节，去用那个章节里面的含义去劝导他们。
You know, you just show, okay, brother, okay, the Bible says sexual immorality is a sin. Example, just let the Bible speak. You don't have to convince.
所以当你不好意思开口的时候，比如说我们谈到一些很敏感的问题，你就可以拿圣经的一个章节，你可以要求他读给你听都好，反正就是你不需要自己开口，因为神早就把他想说的话已经放在圣经里面了。
So we all need to learn to teach. Amen.
所以我们要学会去教导。
So again, who is the one supposed to learn to teach? Only the leader?
所以现在要去学习教导的是谁？只有我们的组长吗？
It's all of us. Learn to teach one another.
是我们当中的全部人，我们都要学习如何去教导别人。
All right, next one. Counsel one another.
然后来到下一个，我们要去彼此的劝诫。
Let's read Colossians chapter 3, verse 16.
一起来读哥罗西书第3章第16节。 你们要让基督的道丰丰富富的住在你们心里，以各样的智慧彼此教导，互相劝诫，用诗章、圣词、灵歌，怀着感恩的心歌颂神。All
right, so here talks about what? Teaching? Counseling.
这里提到了关于教导还有劝诫。
Okay, we already talked about teach. That's teaching directly from the word of God.
所以我们这里刚刚提到过的教导就是用神的话语去教导彼此。So
counsel is more from what? Your personal experience and opinion.
然后劝诫呢是更多的关于我们个人的经验还有我们自己的看法。Because,
you know, some of us, you've been through many different experiences in life. Whether it's overcoming struggle or, you know, learning how to grow in a certain area.
那在我们的生命当中呢，我们总是会有各种各样的经验，比如我们会去克服某一个困难，或者是我们在一些成长上的地方有我们自己的心得。Okay,
so learn to share your experience to one another.
所以我们就要学习如何去分享我们这些经历给彼此。
You know, example, you see a particular parent having difficulty with the child.
所以我们做一个比方，当你现在看到有一个家长，他跟他的孩子之间有一些关系上的问题。
Okay, then you can share your experience in how you help your child.
所以这个时候呢，你就可以大方的向他分享你的一些经验，对于怎样跟你的孩子这样相处。
Now, it doesn't mean it always works. But this is your experience. It's up to that person whether they want to listen or not to your advice.
当然，有时候我们自己的方法并不是在所有地方都管用。但是聆听的人呢，他可以自己去判断，就是他要不要使用你的方法。Okay.
Or if a particular brother want to grow more in making friends and be more loving.
然后比如说今天有一个弟兄，他想要学习如何的去与其他人之间有更好的关系，他想广阔一点的去交朋友。So
again, you can share from your experience what helped you to grow to be a more loving person.
然后这个时候呢，你就可以向他去分享你要怎么样能够成为一个更有魅力的人。So
amen, let's look at the next way. Stir one another up towards love and good works.
然后让我们来看接下来一个，我们要彼此的去激励。Let's
read Hebrews chapter 10, verse 23 to 24.
那我们来读希伯来书第10章第23到第24节。又应该坚持我们所宣认的盼望，毫不动摇，因为那是应许我们的，是信实的。 我们又应该彼此关心，激发爱心，勉励行善。All right,
I love the English word here. I don't know how it's translated in Chinese, but in English, it says stir one another up. Motivate one another, inspire one another. But the English word is stir, like stir coffee. Right?
Yeah, I know. 所以我们就要像我们在 pour coffee 的时候一样，我们就像那个咖啡粉，我们就要不停的去搅拌它，直到我们融为一体。Very
good, okay. You stir, right? When you stir, because of the momentum, the sugar melt, the cream melt, everything get mixed together.
就很像那个浓浓一杯 coffee 里面，你一直搅拌它，它的香味就会跑出来。Again,
the action of stirring gives energy. Do the water, right?
搅拌的动作呢，可以让那个水里面充满了能量。Okay,
so stirring very powerful, you know? So we need to learn to stir each other up in the group.
所以我们要学习如何在我们的小组里面应用这个 pour coffee 的技巧。
Exactly. Amen. So in other words, be each other's best fan in the group. You know, best fan, right?
最后一步呢，就是我们学习我们要如何成为我们彼此最大的粉丝。
Okay, you know, we some of us we are fan to idols, right? Wow, BTS, yeah!
这个我熟。
The older one is like, what BTS?
然后我们当中呢，有些人可能是韩国偶像男团 BTS 的狂热粉丝。
Right, you stir, you know, they come in, yeah, BTS, BTS. You don't even mind going to the airport if, you know, if they land in JB Airport, you'll probably be there.
就是你都不需要亲自见到他本人，单单听他的名字，你就想要为他欢呼。
Exactly. Okay, so same thing, you know, we got the really just, right? 加油 yeah, come on, you hang, go for it, you can do it.
所以鼓励人的方法就是最好就是用言语去激励他，就是比如说宇恒，加油。
Amen. Okay, sometimes we need that encouragement, that stirring to help each other to do great works.
那我们作为人呢，我们很时常需要这种激励去推动我们去做得更好。
All right, example, TGIS coming. Do you stir each other up to make sure the TGIS is the best?
然后当我们的 TGIS 或 TGIF 来临的时候，我们是否做好了准备，一起去推动并且鼓励，让我们的这个活动变成最好的
？Okay, so let's see which group has the best.
那让我们来共同期盼我们的当时的表现。
然后 which group the most joyful group?
然后期盼我们成为那个最开心的队伍。
Right, so have some friendly competition among each of the group.
然后当然我们当中也会存在很多竞争。
Alright, so stir one another up towards love and good deeds.
但是它是基于我们的激励的行为上，所以我们要更加努力的去让我们的小组去。
Okay. And the last point of how to grow together, very important. Be humble to learn from one another.
然后我们最后一点呢，就是也是很重要的，就是我们要彼此谦卑的去学习。
So let's read 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 5.
让我们来读彼得前书第五章第五节。照样，你们青年人要顺服年长的，就是你们个人也要彼此以谦卑为装束，因为神抵挡骄傲的人，赐恩给谦卑的人。
I love this verse. The Bible says, "What clothe yourself with humility, become humble."
所以神这边就是劝导我们，我们要变得谦卑。
Humility is not something you do.
谦卑不是我们正在做一样事情。
It's something that you become.
是我们即将要成为的一个。
So learn to practice humility. In your heart until you learn to become a humble person.
所以我们要打从我们内心呢去学习如何变得谦卑，那样我们才能真正的变得很谦卑。
Okay, so a humble person is willing to be taught.
一个谦卑的人呢是会很愿意的去学习。
Right, where you're willing to ask one another, hey bro, what do you think in my life I need to grow in?
那举一个很好的例子呢，就是你可以去问你的弟兄姐妹们，比如说弟兄，我现在你觉得我有什么需要去成长的呢？
Okay, or if a brother give you feedback, then you appreciate it. You say, hey, thank you, bro, for telling me the things that I need to grow.
然后所以呢，我们谦卑的人他在听取了他需要成长的地方呢，他会向那个提供建议的人道谢，就是比如说。弟兄，谢谢你去告诉我这一点，让我知道我哪里需要去成长。
Okay, and if someone warn you about, you know, temptation and sin, don't go there and challenge them and say, "Well, bro, why you challenging me or warning me?"
所以呢，一个谦卑的人，他不会在听到一些，比如说他们对你有期盼的事情上呢，他不会说，我觉得我已经做得够好了，你怎么能这样子讲我？
You know, rather say, hey, bro, thank you. Let me think about your advice and let me see how to change.
然后谦卑人呢就会说， 哎，我已经下定决心，我要改变了。我以后会让你看到我的成长。
Okay, so learn to be humble. Very important. When you're humble, you grow very fast.
嗯，所以呢，这边我们就要学习，我们要变得谦卑，因为当我们谦卑的时候呢，我们就会成长得很快。
Amen. Those are the six ways.
嗯 ，Amen. 以上就是我们要提到的六个要点。
So next week for your D group, I have a very exciting work for all of you.
嗯，然后我们下个礼拜的 D group 呢，然后我们就很期待，我们可以在我们的小组里面讨论啊，我们去获益。
So use these six ways in your group. Ask feedback, bro. What do you think? You see my life very clear. What do you think? You think I need to grow in one area? Tell me.
嗯，然后我们就可以在小组里面问我们彼此呢，诶，弟兄，你觉得我有什么在我生命里面需要去改变、需要去成长的呢？然后我们可以把那个区域列出来。
Okay, or the other way is, let's say, you know, everybody say, oh, I don't know. Hey, sometimes it shows your group, I don't know you, you know, when they say don't know. Then you can ask, bro, I'm trying to be a more patient person. What do you think can help me?
嗯，然后如果你这个时候你想问你的就是弟兄姐妹，如果我想要成为一个更加 patient，更加有耐心的人，那么我能做什么呢？
Okay, or whatever, you know, bro, I want to learn how to pray more. What do you think? Can you give me some ideas? Then you hear from different brothers in your group or different sisters in your group, and learn from their feedback.
嗯，或是你可以问彼此，如果我想要变得更会祷告，那么我能做什么呢？
Okay, and those who are giving feedback, make sure you give it in a very loving and kind and compassionate way.
嗯，当然呢，我们作为给别人建议的那一方，我们也要用很，怎么说，很亲切，然后很不会伤害到人的方法去劝导他。
Okay, don't think of that time. Wow, bro, I'm going to go for it. You know how many, I want to tell you this so many years already. Don't do that.
然后这个时候别人来请教你的时候呢，你不能说哇，我想讲你很久了啊，你终于给我找到机会了。
Amen. Okay, this is fun. For some of us who are younger, this will be a new experience. Amen.
Oh,
amen. Oh. Thank you, Yu Heng. I think he did a marvelous job, right?
Yes. Amen.
Okay, let's break up for fellowship. Thank you.